How's it going, YouTube? Mitch Santoni here with Transformers Masterpiece MP11 Coronation Starscream. I'm going to give you a little spin around of the box here. Typical Masterpiece type stuff. And then it shows all of this, shows some new features. Written in Japanese, I can't read it, so I can't tell you what it's all saying. Oh, but it looks really, really nice to my eyeballs. So here we have Starscream out of the box and transformed into his plane mode. Looks pretty cool. Looks really cool. He's very reminiscent here of his G1 counterpart slash the Sunbow cartoon. The blues are a little bit more towards the cartoon. It's a lighter, like a baby blue like he was in the old G1 84, 85 series. Whereas that's kind of the darker blue. But I'll keep this guy around because we're going to do some comparisons in a bit. So here's a side-by-side of the two. This is the original Starscream release and now the MP11. Paint-wise and color-wise, I think the new one is very very dull. It's cartoon-like, but I think it's a downgrade, to be perfectly honest. I think this is a much nicer-looking paint job. Specifically, you see how everything's just a uniform gray, almost like a cartoon? You got this guy, and there's just some weathering and some marking, and just it looks like it almost burnt. It's seen some action, some dirt, but all the lines have been, well, they've been panel lined, so it really does look nice and kind of more realistic. He's got the nice nose cone here that just fades from a darker silver out into a lighter silver, whereas this is just blah. Plus, the original's got that little crown symbol with the wings, whereas this one, nothing. The one thing that is kind of nicer, I think, is the fact that like all the hinge points, which are very invisible on the new one, you can barely tell where they're at, especially from far away, whereas these stand out like a sore thumb. They're black, when they should have been maybe molded in this whiter color. So, yeah, I guess that's an improvement, but for the most part, I think the original Starscream is the winner. Mold-wise, in their alt modes, you really can't tell these two guys apart until you flip them over. So here's the underside of the original Starscream. You can see everything is very compact, very smooth, rounded. And if I flip it on end here, it's a very, very tight profile. Nice, nice, nice. Come to the new guy. You've got some extra junk on it. It's a little bit thicker here. The chunks of it are like squared off more, and they're protruding a lot more. So in his alt mode, I'm going to go with the original as well. This is not as clean as the other one. Now, these bits do have a very good use. It makes for a much better robot mode, but we'll see that shortly. Now, on your original Starscream, you had removable cannons here, which you could be replaced with the missile pods, which I'll show you in a bit, as opposed to these, which, in a nice touch, the missile pods will fit on here, but this can be removed, and they stay on these ball-jointed struts and never have to leave the actual robot, so that when you do transform them, these just can swing out of the way and then back into place on his arms. So that's kind of cool. Alt mode features on this guy. It's pretty much the same as on the original Masterpiece. If you don't own that, though, I'll show them off a little. They do have the two retractable landing gear here. There's a door here. You can do that and then swing this down, and then the big long landing strut comes down. I can't get my finger in there to do it now. Movable flaps, which end up being part of the transformation mode, but it does look cool to have some movable flaps as a plane. He's got the rotating on ball joint here, his little afterburners. He has his air brake, if you can get your finger in there too. Just flip that up, kind of neat. Also, if you can get your fingers in here, you could do these individually or not, or whatever, but there are some engine parts there, so you can flip that up and just view it or showcase it like that if you like. And additionally, he's got that removable nose cone. You pull that forward, you set it to the side, and he's got some radar stuff and all kinds of fun gadgets in there. So your original Masterpiece Starscream came with a little tiny itty-bitty Dr. Arkaville. Even had a little bit of paint on his face there with that crazy helmet that he used to like to wear. The new guy, however, is a little remolded jet fighter pilot. You can see he's got a helmet on with the little hosing. Well, this dude's clear and holographic, bright blue, and just got dropped. Cockpit opens, pilot goes in, cockpit closes, game on.
Remember this stuff? This was from the original. He came with a nice stand. You could display it as a jet mode, or you could pull it out, and you could slide it this way, and you can stand him up. It kind of hung him there, so he could be displayed kind of in a flying position. He also came with some missile pods, and a little baby clip here, which is right over here, that you could plug into this hole underneath his cockpit, and he could hold this accessory, which is this Megatron. The new one comes with none of that stuff. But for the sake of showing it off, it will work with all those accessories that it doesn't include. So far, doing a comparison side by side, I highly recommend the other one. But this guy does get better, so let's explore that right now. I'm going to start to transform this guy and show you guys some of the design changes, some of the engineering changes on this thing, because that is really where this thing shines. If you pull this back part out here, you'll notice that all of this came with it. Whereas on the first edition, he simply transforms like this and these things stay put, which ends up being some pretty nasty kibble. The legs on the new figure are actually a lot more stable due to the engineering changes, and they look a little more aesthetically pleasing as well in this mode. Even on the backside where we had those engines exposed, these now are able to flip down and give him a better heel spur so he's more able to stand on his own. Plus he's still got the adjustability of this to give him some poseability. And now since all this is hanging down so low, you simply slide these up on another little component and there you go. Nice clean leg. Move those, pull them up here. And then you can begin work on this stuff here. Now you can see there's some additional extra material here as opposed to on the other versions of these long spikes. Whereas on the original, he had these little panels that somehow stick up there somewhere. You know what? Every time and every seeker I have of this mold, I just pull these off and throw them aside because they never stay on right on mine, so I would call that an improvement. As always, the pain in the butt middle portion of these things is still a pain in the butt. Okay, so here's where it gets kind of cool. After you flip this down, I don't know if you saw that or not, but the little things on the head, they're spring-loaded now, so they pop out and make for a better Starscream. Here is the side-by-side. You can see one has got these big, long sides of the plane skirting on it that I end up usually just popping off, and it's really hard to pop off because the ball joint is super tight. So yes, the original has a lot of junk as compared to this, which is very, very neat. Although we have these little wingtips extra hanging down, they're not very obtrusive, not like that, so I gotta give the edge to this guy here. The poseability and the hands and everything are the exact same thing. He's got the one movable finger with the three that are connected, and those are on ball joints as well as his thumbs on ball joints. He's got a nice blue, powder blue metallic paint on this whole forearm area, so that's really cool. Also, on the original's arm, you can see like a big chunk of plane right there, which is off color. It's the plane color. The new one's arms are clean because all of the white, or the gray in this case, is now on the bottom of his leg. That all pulled away in the transformation, so really cool there because now his arms are much cleaner, look a lot nicer and more cartoon accurate. Plus, this isn't just on a swiveling peg, it's on a ball joint, which is on that, in turn, on that strut. So it can be posed in a lot of different ways and basically get out of the way of any kind of arm motion you want it to do. And he still retains the missile nipple gimmick, so that's kind of cool. And here's just a little closer look at those little adjustable. They just rock back and forth, so when you open his legs up and spread them, they don't get in the way. So that looks kind of nice. Here's the original head sculpt, one of two. Now you can flip this and give him a serious stern face if you'd like, but I think this is the better of the two. It's just a cocky smile. But you can see how thin his head is, and it's not very Starscream-like. This guy looks like a, I don't know, some sort of a Greek statue with the expression. That, however, is wicked-looking. That is just freaking cool. I love that look all day long, baby. That is the win. One last thing before I get on to the accessories for this guy is this one has no chance at all without that crazy stand of standing on his own. Except when I say that on camera, and here he is, just perfect. Okay, the other one really isn't that stable. That was just kind of a fluke. He will fall down at the slightest breeze, and he did the second I touched him off camera. This guy, however, you put him wherever you want, you can bend him around. He will hold a pose because he's got basically these back foot pads here that really hold him up, really make for a nice little addition to the engineering on this. Now for the coronation of Starscream. Comes with a beautifully molded purple plastic cape that billows out and spreads. Look at that. Also comes with a pair of royal shoulder plates. Snap right on. And the final piece to the puzzle, the Decepticon crown, which we saw for 30 seconds in 30 years. Here it is, baby, before it was vaporized by Galvatron. Sorry if I'm spoiling it, but yeah, this doesn't last long, but here it is. So to get the shoulder pads on, he's got these little square peg holes that rotate out, and the other version has them as well. Now this thing here has got the other adapting piece. You can slide that on nice and tight. And the nice part about it is it's very adjustable, so he's still got poseability, even with these gargantuan things on his arms. You'll notice here he's got this little cutout profile that matches up with that. You can slide this over that ever so nicely, and it should snap into place just like so. The best part about the design of this cape is that you can have it less or more, depending on the mood. And even with all that back weight on him now, he's still standing like a champion. I crown you King of the Decepticons. On original Starscream, the crown goes on loose, the cape fits perfectly, but these guys here are too thin for the older, wider arms. So, just in case you're wondering. And one last thing, MP11 does work on the original stand. So thank you very much for watching, everybody. This has been Mitch Santona. Appreciate you stopping by. Hope this review helped you make a decision as to what you like is in your masterpiece Starscreams. Me personally, for alt modes, I go with the original one because that is a great alt mode. I think the paint is much better. It's nicer. It's more detailed. You can put the missiles on. It's this little sleeker profile. But robot mode, this dude takes the cake. The engineering changes were great that they made to it. I think it really improved the figure as a robot. And I do like the fact that he's got a crown and a cape and some fancy little shoulder pads. See you later, everybody. Good night. Arrivederci. And I'll catch you on the flip side.